So, we are ready to go, it looks like. And so, I just wanted to, first of all, welcome everybody to our first back porch chit-chat. So we're just going to sit back here and shoot the breeze. And we're going to learn a few different things about, just a different emergency scenarios, different, self-reliance type topics, and things like that. And we're going to study those. And, of course, when I first decided to do this, we were getting a series of about, 5-6 days in a row of 90-plus degrees. And so I set the date for this, and here we go. It is about to rain. So we'll see how long this goes. And I hear thunder going on upstairs there. So this is going to be really interesting. But we'll see how long we can make this last. I'd like to welcome everybody to this, back porch chat. And hopefully you guys will find this educational. The first person I thought of to do this with was Paul Munsen. And I, one of the things, and I talked about this briefly in one of the videos, is that one of the things that a friend of mine said that survived Hurricane Sandy was that his friends and family turned on him faster than he thought when they were hungry. And that just doesn't have to be. And he said he didn't have access to wood, he didn't have access to anything. And so I asked him. I said, how was the weather? What did it look like? And he said it was cloudy, but then it cleared up. He had access to a roof. He had access to sun in his yard. And I thought, this is the perfect opportunity for, something like this to talk to Paul Munsen about with the sun ovens. And just to give you guys an example, and I didn't tell anybody I was going to do this, I've been running around with work today, so I've been really busy and been slammed. But the one thing I did do, and I'm gonna grab my camera here and flip it around, is I had my wife set out our sun oven, and I had her cook my favorite thing, which is hot wings. And I think they're gonna be done here in just a few minutes, and I'll. I'm gonna pull those out because I have not eaten all day, so I'm gonna be nibbling on those on the side maybe. But anyway, the sun oven can be used whether it's an emergency, whether it's not an emergency. Paul Munsen has been doing this for what has it been? 18 years, Paul?
18 years now.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. This guy knows more about cooking with the sun than probably anybody on the planet. He's addressed. I believe it was United Nations Commissions?
United Nations Commission on Sustainable Development.
Mm-hmm. Oh, my goodness. Yeah, and the UN headquarters in New York. He's just very, very knowledgeable when it comes to sun ovens, and I really wanted to have him on here because I felt like it was just such a missed opportunity in a lot of emergency scenarios, and people don't understand, how to cook with the sun properly. They don't understand how to harness that power, and a lot of people think, well, I can just put some tin foil in a metal in a cardboard box, and trust me, I've tried that. It didn't work. So there's all kinds of do-it-yourself things on YouTube, and I've tried a bunch of those, and nothing has been able to work like Paul and using the sun oven. And so I thought, what better person to have on for our backyard chat than Paul. So without further ado, Paul, speak up, buddy. Here, I mean,
right. Thanks so much. Appreciate it's an honor to join you for backyard chat. I haven't had lunch either, or dinner. So I envy you because I'm actually in my office and don't have access to the sun now. So I'll be thinking about those hot wings when I go to the class here. So.
Oh, the glass is steamed up here. I think I'm going to pull them out real quick while you're talking. So go ahead.
Sounds good. All right, Peter, you want to put on the first slide, and we'll just kind of talk about some of the housekeeping things with the class tonight, and then we'll go through. So hopefully we'll have the first slide here in just a minute. Okay, so next. So tonight we do, Ron's going to be watching questions. I'm going to be talking and teaching, and I don't know if you can see Ron on the bottom there with, he's got his hot wings and he's all ready to go. So, but please, there is the box below, submit your questions, and if we don't get to your question tonight, I'm going to get them via email and I'll respond back to you with the email. If you are having any issues with seeing this, you might want to hit the reload or refresh button on your computer, and that should straighten it out. And if you want to see a larger version of this, all you need to do is click that little symbol that's in the lower right-hand corner. Next. And so I just want to explain a little bit about... I've worked with Sun Ovens, as we said, for a long time. We have Sun Ovens all over the world, and I've had the opportunity to teach Sun Oven cooking on 5 different continents. And the picture on the screen was one that was taken in Haiti after the earthquake on one of my trips there. And so my wife and I really do make a real practice of self-reliance. We live on a 3-acre home, 3 1/4-acre homestead in DeKalb County, Illinois. Our nearest neighbor is about a half mile away, surrounded by cornfields, and we grow a lot of our own food and chickens and a whole variety of different things. So I've had a lot of the advantage of being able to work with Sun Ovens around the world has been that I've been able to really get a lot of hands-on experience of how things will work. And then, Peter, we can go and go to the next slide then. And so the goals for tonight's class is we want to try to help you to use your Sun Oven. I'm sure there's some people watching who have bought Sun Ovens and have never used them. Some people get intimidated and think it's hard, and Ron will be the first person to tell you it's pretty hard to screw anything up in it. It really works very, very well, as you can tell with his eating the chicken there. So we're going to cover cooking and baking and how you boil, how you steam foods, and we're also going to talk about purifying water and roasting meats and dehydrating and just living off-grid and being a little better prepared for emergencies. And if there was a power failure, how would you cook? And we think that the easiest way to cook in the event of a long-term power failure is tomorrow morning when you get up, look east, and you'll see the solution rising. It comes up every morning right from the east, and that's the sun. So next, the sun is a great way to be better prepared for emergencies. A lot of people prepare with food storage, but storing fuel for a long time can be very expensive and dangerous. Next. And so having a way to cook when there's no power can really make a big difference. If you're storing butane, for example, or propane, the seals on the canisters are only good for 5 years. And during the Y2K time, we had bartered some Sun Ovens with some people who had a lot of butane as a backup for the Sun Oven, and I went to move several years later and opened the boxes. Every single one of the cans was empty because the seals had given away. With propane, it's the same thing. It's a 5-year life on the seal, but you never know when it was filled, so it's hard to sometimes date those things. One thing I do want to mention, because a lot of people do store propane for their emergency preparedness, is that if you do have propane stored, you want to make sure that you know how much propane you can legally store. It's not that there's going to be a propane policeman knocking on the door to confiscate your propane. However, if you have more propane stored than what you're legally allowed to, and you ever had a fire, your homeowner's insurance would be voided. So you want to make sure that if you are storing propane, you know how much you can have. Check with your local building department or fire department. In most communities, and I'm not talking about if you've got a big external propane tank, but if you've got canisters of propane, in most places you can only store 2 20-pound canisters, 2 of the canisters that you would exchange at a local hardware store or gas station. Next. So using a Sun Oven in the event of emergency preparedness can really be to your advantage, particularly if you've got preparedness foods. If you've got freeze-dried or dehydrated foods, the Sun Oven is by far the most energy-efficient way to rehydrate your freeze-dried or emergency preparedness foods. When you Normally, if you look at the cans or the packages of preparedness foods, they'll tell you to boil a certain amount of water first and then pour the boiling water over it and stir it and mix it until you get the right consistency. Well, at most altitudes, water boils at 212 degrees, but it takes as much energy to bring water from 200 degrees to 212 as it does from the ambient temperature up to 200. That's why a watch pot never boils. So when you use the sun oven, you don't have to boil the water first. If you take whatever the formula on the can says and use 25% less water. So if the can says take and boil 4 cups of water for each cup of what you want to rehydrate, just do 3. Just take the water at the ambient temperature, room temperature, put it in a pot, mix it together, and then put it in a pot with a lid in the sun oven, and you'll find it will rehydrate perfectly without boiling the water first. Besides for saving a lot of energy, one thing that many people are concerned about when it comes to emergency preparedness is the whole idea of potable water. And if you need 25% less of your water to rehydrate your preparedness foods, that's a lot less water that you have to have treated and ready to go. So as I continue, before I go further explaining about cooking in the sun, I thought it'd be easier to, for those of you who aren't familiar with the sun oven, we made just a 2-minute video that explains how the sun oven works, and then we'll talk about what we can do with it. So Peter, could you start the video, please?
Hi, I'd like to invite you to learn more about the All-American Sun Oven. An All-American Sun Oven can bake and boil and steam foods just with the power of the sun. It also can be used as a solar dryer, dehydrator, or to boil or pasteurize drinking water. The Sun Oven is designed so the whole thing just sets up in a matter of seconds. It's a simple one-piece construction. It has a leg built into the back that allows you to raise or lower it to be able to meet the sun wherever it is in the horizon. So in the early morning, late afternoon, or winter, you'd have it raised up. In the summer, most of the time, you have it pretty much sitting close to the ground. And setting up the oven, as I say, it was very simple. You just open this glass door, you put your food in the oven's chamber, and then there's 2 latches that allow you to latch the glass door shut to trap the heat inside. A sun oven will reach temperatures of between 360 on a perfect day, 400 degrees Fahrenheit, and you can pretty much cook anything you want in it. The nice thing is, if you do realign it to follow the sun, your food isn't going to spill when you move it to follow the sun because it has this leveling tray. It has a built-in thermometer so you can tell the temperature at a glance, and there's absolutely no hassle to figuring out when the sun oven's aligned. It comes with these easy track alignment cubes. You just point the sun oven towards the sun. There's 2 holes in each of the cubes. The sun shines through the top hole. When you have it centered over the bottom hole, then you know the sun oven is adjusted to exactly where the sun needs, where it needs to be in the sunlight. The sun oven, you can take your food out of it. Obviously, I've only had this food in now for a matter of seconds, so there's nothing. These pots in for a matter of seconds are not really hot, but you always would need to use oven mitts or hot pads if you were going to do it. But just fold it back up to store it. You just fold it like this. It carries like a suitcase. You can put it away until the next time you're ready to harness the power of the sun for your cooking needs.
So that gives you a brief idea of how the sun oven works. And maybe we can, Peter, if we could move on with the next slide. And even though we call it an oven, a sun oven is able to bake, it's able to boil, it's able to steam foods with the power of the sun. So you can cook pretty much anything that you cook on your stovetop or your regular oven, with the exception of fried foods. So it's not limited just to baking. Anything that you boil or steam can be made in the sun oven as well. Next. It also can be used to dehydrate or to boil water, and we're going to cover those things in more detail as we move forward. Next, the wonderful thing about it is that when you cook in the sun, your food never burns. The sun oven has an airtight chamber, so food doesn't dry and it doesn't burn. The reason it doesn't burn is the entire chamber is the same temperature. So when you have a pot of food inside the sun oven, the food inside the pot itself, the air around the pot, are all exactly the same temperature. So the reason that food doesn't dry out is there's no movement of air. So I'm sure Ron will tell us when we come back that the chicken he ate was really moist, and no matter what you make in the sun oven, any kind of a roast, it's amazing how moist it comes out because it doesn't dry out, or when you make bread, it has an unparalleled taste and texture. My wife would be the first person to tell you she thinks I'm a terrible cook, but I go all over the world teaching people to cook, and people think I'm a world-class cook, and the reality is I don't know what I'm doing, but the sun oven just makes it so easy and the food so good that it works out well. Next. Now, the way the sun oven works is it works pretty much with the greenhouse effect. Actually, 60% of the energy for the sun oven comes from the sun shining directly into the oven's chamber. The remaining 40% comes from light that reflects off the reflectors, and the principle is pretty simple. It's pretty much the same as if you were to go out to your car on a day when it's cold and sunny and you suddenly get into your car and you can't see the steering. When you touch the steering wheel, it's almost too hot to touch. Well, that's pretty much the way the sun oven works. So it's able to then just trap the air like greenhouse effect. It gets really hot. We've designed the sun oven in a way that allows you to be able to maximize the temperature inside of it, so it gets up to temperatures of 360 to 400 degrees Fahrenheit. Next, but there's two ways to cook in the sun oven. Let's say you're going to make a 3-pound chicken. If you put a 3-pound chicken in a pot and you put it in the sun oven, if you realign the sun oven every 30 minutes to follow the sun, you can cook a 3-pound chicken in about an hour and a half. Or you could take a frozen chicken, you could put it in the sun oven in the morning, set the oven facing south, leave for the day and come back at supper time and have a cooked roast. So if you realign the sun oven every 30 minutes, your cooking time is only going to be about 15 minutes longer for each time you open the door of the sun oven than it would be in your stovetop or your regular oven. So it's very forgiving if you want to cook quickly. It can cook almost the same time as a stovetop or oven. Or by realigning it every 30 minutes, you can keep it at that temperature, or you can slow cook all day with it. Next. The real advantage, though, of the sun oven is how quickly it pays for itself. It pays for itself somewhat in what you save in cooking fuel. The average American family spends about 14% of their utility budget on cooking fuel. But if you do your baking outdoors, it really reduces the cost of your air conditioning bills, your cooling costs. Most people find they pay for a sun oven in a relatively short period of time just by using it. Some people have told us what they really like to do is after they keep track of how much they save by using their sun oven, and then once they paid for the sun oven, the money they save by using it is able to then, they continue to keep track of it, they use that to fund their food storage and other emergency preparedness supplies. Next. The other thing keep in mind is you can use a sun oven year-round. The outside temperature doesn't make any difference at all. The main thing is just the amount of direct sunlight. Now, the rule of thumb is pretty simple. Just think of the groundhog. If you can see your shadow, then you can cook. If you can't see your shadow, then it's overcast at a point you can't cook in the sun oven. But the outside temperature doesn't make any difference. It can be zero and sunny, and it would be better than a day when it would be 100 degrees and overcast. And you can use the sun oven year-round. There are a couple of differences in using the sun oven in the summer versus the winter. One is that in June you can use the sun oven 12 and a half or 13 hours a day. In December you can use it about 5 hours a day. Also the preheating time. Normally you can preheat a sun oven to about 300 degrees in about 20 minutes, but in the winter, if you've had the sun oven stored outside, the inner box of the sun oven is metal, and if it's starting at a colder temperature, it sometimes takes about twice as long to preheat the sun oven. Next. Now, one of the great things in the sun oven so many people really like, and it's got a very important part of a lot of people's emergency preparedness plans, is baking bread. When you bake bread in the sun oven, you'll be amazed at the taste and the texture that you get with it. You do absolutely need to preheat the sun oven if you are going to bake bread in it, but there's a couple things you do just a little bit different. One is that when you raise the bread, you don't proof it to the full height. when you're going to bake bread in the sun oven, what you want to do is let the dough raise until it's about a half to three quarters of an inch below the top of the bread pan. The reason for that is the even heat of the sun oven. When you, let's say you preheat the sun oven to 325 degrees and you open the door and put two loaves of bread in, well, the bread's at the ambient temperature, that's going to drop the temperature in the sun oven down 50 to 75 degrees, and then it's going to gradually increase again. Well, if you've already raised your bread to its full height, when that temperature drops and then comes back up again, there's a good chance your bread will over-raise and fall. So if you take and you just let it raise to just below the top of the bread pan, when that temperature drops, then comes back up, your bread will raise to just the right height. Another thing to keep in mind is that when you bake bread in the sun oven, if you take a spray bottle and you spray a light mist of water on the dough, then you'll get a nice brown crust even if you don't have full temperature in the sun oven. So if you spray the dough with water, some people like using butter or egg wash, they'll do the same thing, but just plain water will give you a brown crust. Now, you can bake white bread, or you can make wheat bread, or sourdough bread, or gluten-free bread. So pretty much any kind of bread that you want to make, you can make in the sun oven. Normally, if I'm baking white or wheat bread, I can make one loaf in about 45 minutes. Two loaves take an hour and 10 minutes. But this past weekend, we were doing a renewable energy show where I had sun ovens out in the sun and was cooking, and as people would come and stand in front of the oven, they'd be blocking the sun throughout the day, so the temperatures in the sun oven that I was baking the bread in rarely got above 275 degrees, but it just took a little longer and the bread baked just fine. So it's an incredibly good way to bake bread. You'll be amazed at the taste and texture, but also how easy it is. People send us emails all the time telling us they've baked bread in the sun oven and forgotten that it was out there, leave it in an extra hour or two, and they come out thinking their bread's not going to be any good, and they can't tell the difference in the taste. So it's an amazingly forgiving way to bake bread. Next, another thing that's really delicious in the sun oven is beans. When you make beans in the sun oven, you get flavors you just don't get any other way. It's incredible how yummy is about the only way I can describe it. The beans come out when you cook them in the sun. When you do beans in the sun oven, there's so many different types of beans that giving a time is difficult. But just like with the chicken I mentioned, if you realign the oven every 30 minutes, you would be able to cook pretty much the same time as your regular stovetop. You do that with the beans too. You can bring them to a boil and keep them boiling, or you can slowly simmer them all day and generally use about 2.5 cups of water for each cup of dried beans, but you'll be absolutely amazed at the flavor of it. Next, another really delicious thing to make in the sun oven is a turkey. You can make up to a 21-pound turkey in the current model of the sun oven or an 18-pound turkey in the original sun oven in a baking bag. You'll be absolutely amazed at how moist the turkey is when you make it in the sun oven. Now, when you bake a turkey in the sun oven, we do suggest you put it in a baking bag. On the packages, on the baking bag packaging, it will tell you that you should cut slits in the baking bag, but don't do that in the sun oven. Just tie the baking bag really tight, put the turkey inside of it, and that will trap all the moisture inside. And if you rub some butter or olive oil or sprinkle paprika on the skin, you'll get a golden brown turkey. Anytime I've ever made a turkey, anybody who's eaten it has said the light meat is more moist than the dark meat turkey they've ever eaten. So it's an incredibly delicious way to make turkey. And by the way, if you've got a freezer at Thanksgiving time, a lot of the stores put turkeys on sale as a loss leader to get you to buy all the fixins. And if you buy turkeys at Thanksgiving time, put them in your freezer, nothing's more fun than a day when it's 90 or 100 degrees outside and everybody's complaining about how hot it is, tell your friends you're at home making a turkey. And if you buy it at the holidays, it's cheaper than hamburger, and then you have delicious leftovers for sandwiches and things after that. Well, Ron, I've been talking quite a bit. Has anybody submitted any questions so far?
Yeah, we actually got quite a few questions here. Trisha asks, she said that she's used the chopstick trick on the condensation issue when she's baking bread, but it still is having condensation problems. Do you have any other suggestions for her?
Okay, well, just to explain for those who aren't familiar with it, sometimes moisture builds up on the glass of the sun oven, and the sun oven is an airtight seal. So if you do get moisture building up on the glass, then what we suggest that you do is open the glass quickly, wipe the condensation off the glass, and then take a chopstick and put it in the upper right-hand corner of the sun oven, right above one of the latches. The chopstick, the tip of it inside the oven, the other part sticking out, and that breaks the seal. If it's something that is, if you've got a chronic problem with bread, with that, then you might want to actually turn the chopstick around, loosen the screws just a little bit, use the thicker end inside of it. That will leave a little bigger gap, it'll lower the temperature a little more, but it'll keep the moisture from building up on the glass.
Yeah, that makes sense. I mean, condensation buildup, she just needs to open it up more until she doesn't have any condensation buildup. Okay, so the next one is, I believe it, Rabbi. And it says, do you produce one that's larger, a commercial version? And do you have small portable versions, or do you just have the one shown?
The for sale in the U.S., we really only have the one shown. We do make a large commercial size solar oven, we call a villager sun oven. I'll be showing some pictures of that a little bit later, but the villager sun oven can make 1,200 meals in an 8-hour day, and we have, or 28 loaves of bread an hour. We used to sell those in the United States, but it's designed to be to work with absolutely no maintenance for 15 years. And so people in the U.S. want something more automated and something that's a little bit slicker, so we stopped selling them in the U.S. Six, 7 years ago, and but we do sell those for developing countries. There was a smaller version of the sun oven, but it just didn't cook enough food, so people didn't buy it, so it was discontinued. So there's only one size sun oven. The current model is called the All-American Sun Oven, and that can cook enough food for a family of six people.
Hey, man, I got seven kids, man. I need the village-sized version.
That's for sure. You just need to get a second oven.
Yeah, no kidding. Okay, so what about the risk of salmonella when cooking meat?
Okay, the danger zone for meats is you don't want meat to be between 40 degrees and 150 degrees for 90 consecutive minutes. So if you preheat a sun oven before you put a meat in, of course, then there's no issue whatsoever. I mentioned earlier you could cook like a chicken or a roast all day. And with that, if you, let's say you put a, we suggest you start with a frozen chicken if you're going to leave it unattended all day. If you put a frozen chicken in the sun oven at 8 o'clock in the morning and you set the oven facing where the sun's going to be at noon, what's going to happen is from 8 to 10, it's going to be defrosting. From 10 to 2, the sun will be directly overhead and will be cooking. Once it gets warm, it will stay warm for a good 5-6 hours after the sun's not directly overhead. So in that cycle, there's never any time that the meat is going to be between 40 degrees and 150 degrees for 90 consecutive minutes. Now, by the way, that works real good with frozen roasts under 4 pounds. You don't want to do it with a larger roast. You do, if you're going to do the turkey, need to make sure that you completely defrost the turkey first. But if you have a roast under 4 pounds, you can start with it frozen, and then if you're going to slow cook it, you don't have to worry about salmonella. And then, but if you preheat it, of course, then there's no issue with it. So Ron's going to continue to monitor your questions.
One more?
Okay, sure. All righty.
Mike asks, he goes, what is the difference between this your sun oven and my homemade version? I can tell you yours sucks.
I can't.
I've tried it a bunch of times and they suck. Every time I've tried it, they don't work. Man, they just don't work. Tell us. All right, Paul, tell us the secret, man. Why does yours work better than all the ones that I've...
Basically, the way that the sun oven works better than a homemade solar cooker is that the sun oven has a gasket in it, and that gasket forms an airtight seal. The gasket's never going to fail, but that airtight seal makes a huge difference. But also the engineering of the sun oven is designed so the reflectors are exactly the right height for the amount of cubic inches of the glass that it's going into, and the way that it's insulated. In a few minutes we'll talk more about how the sun oven is made, but because of those things, the sun oven is the only type of box-type solar cooker that allows you to choose whether you want to cook at almost the same time as a regular oven or slow cook. Most solar cookers can only slow cook. There are some homemade solar cookers that sometimes can make bread on really perfect days, but the sun oven can make bread on partly cloudy days. So the number of days you can use it is longer, the temperature gets a lot hotter, and as you saw in the video, there's a lot of user-friendly features, like that your food doesn't spill when you realign it to follow the sun, and the way that the leg in the back allows you to meet the sun on the horizon. With the current model now, we have the easy track indicators, so there's no guesswork of knowing how to align it with the sun, and all those things make a big difference between that and a homemade oven. So we'll continue on. We will stop again for questions again in a few minutes, and then at the end, next. And so now I want to talk about making eggs. When you make eggs in the sun oven, you can make hard-boiled eggs with no water. And the advantage of doing that next is that when you make the eggs in the sun oven without the water, freshly laid eggs are very, very easy to peel. Next, anybody who's ever taken a fresh egg, hard-boiled it, when it after they haven't stored it for a while, just taken it fresh and hard-boiled it, knows that it's just about impossible to peel a freshly laid egg. You cut your fingers, you cut your, you know, it's just so frustrating. Usually by the time that you've peeled it, it doesn't even seem worth eating. Well, in the sun oven, if you hard-boil the egg without water, what happens then is you can take an egg. We raise chickens, and I've taken eggs within 20 minutes of dropping out of the chicken, hard-boiled them in the sun oven, and they peel instantly. Now, of course, most people just put their eggs in the refrigerator and date them if they want to hard-boil them and then cook them at a, hard-boil them at a later date. But in a preparedness situation, if you didn't have refrigeration, having a way that you could hard-boil your eggs immediately could really be to your advantage. Now, if you put a whole bunch of eggs in a pot, anywhere the eggs touch each other, you're going to get a brown spot on the white of the egg. However, if you take cardboard egg cartons and you rip them the lids off of them, you can put 24 eggs into the sun oven at the same time, and they come out perfect. Next. Now, when I do 24 eggs in the sun oven, what I usually do is preheat the sun oven, and then we'll take and put the 24 eggs in for about an hour. After an hour, I'll take one egg out, set it on a flat surface like a table, and spin it. If it spins nice and evenly like a top, then I know that the egg is done. If it's real wobbly, if you ever try spinning a hard-boiled egg, you'll see it spins evenly. You spin a soft-boiled egg, it wobbles. If it's still wobbly, I'll put it back in for about another 15 minutes, and you'll have perfect eggs every time, and it really works well. By the way, if you have refrigerated your eggs before you hard-boil them in the sun oven, it's best to take the eggs out of the sun oven for at least 30 minutes or so and let them stand so that you're able to then and then put them in. If you start with cold eggs, they don't come out quite right, but if you start with eggs that have been at the that have never been refrigerated or been out of the refrigerator for 30 minutes, they come out perfect. Next. Now, there's a number of other things that we can use the sun oven for. It can be used to boil or pasteurize water, and we'll cover that a little more thoroughly. It's great for making sun tea. You can also use it as a solar dryer or dehydrator to make dehydrate fruits or vegetables or make jerky. Another important use of the sun oven is hot water. And as I've talked to people about their emergency preparedness plans, people have plans for drinking water, but very few people ever consider hot water. You know, the average American family uses more energy every day to heat water than they do to cook. Think of the number of times today you turn on a hot water faucet. So you need hot water even in a preparedness situation for things like personal hygiene or doing dishes or laundry. So you're able to heat water in the sun oven. You can actually, there's two stackable pots that come with the sun oven and with most of the packages we offer that allow you then to cook two different things at the same time. But there's enough room if you want to while you're cooking. You can actually put two quart-sized mason jars in and be heating water to be able to do the dishes at the same time. Or as soon as you take your food out, you can start heating the water. It can also be used to kill any infestations that may have gotten into your grains or dried foods. If you put any bug-infested grains or dried foods in the sun oven, you bring it up to 145 degrees for 10 minutes, that will kill off not just the live bugs, but the bugs in any stage of development. It also can be used to sterilize medical instruments. A number of groups who have taken medical missions trips have taken and take sun ovens with them. They'll heat water, clean the instruments thoroughly, and then they literally steam them like an autoclave, and it was a way that you could make sure medical instruments are completely sterilized. If your kindling wood has gotten wet, you can dry it in the sun oven. If you're into sprouting, you can enhance your winter sprouting in the sun oven. Next, and on days when it's overcast and you can't cook in the sun oven, then you can use it as a retained heat cooker or wonder box. A lot of the preparedness manuals talk about wonder boxes or wonder baskets as a way of doing it. The concept of retained heat cooking is pretty simple. What you do is get your food half-cooked using a conventional fuel source. Then you take the half-cooked food and you put it into a very well-insulated box, and the retained heat will allow it to finish cooking. Well, the sun oven is extremely well insulated, so on days when you can't see a shadow or you're not able to cook in the sun oven, you can leave it in the house, put your half-cooked food into it, latch the glass door shut, just leave the reflectors sitting on top of it, and then it will work very well as a wonder box or retained heat cooker. Next, I do want to mention that the sun ovens are made in the United States, and all of the parts for the sun oven are made in the U.S. with the exception of the thermometer. They've actually been on the market for 29 years. Next. And they were made with the idea that we could use them in a developing country for 15 years with absolutely no maintenance. So if you use them in the U.S., they will last a lifetime. Last month, we were at the Mother Earth News Fair in Wisconsin, and the inventor of the sun oven was from Wisconsin, and he started making the ovens in 1985, and I took over from him in 1998. But I had so many people come up to me that told me that they had bought ovens from the inventor back in the 80s, and they were still using them because there's really nothing can go wrong with it. So it's very durable, it's very reliable. Next, and the materials that go into the sun oven are really important. There's the gasket, as I mentioned, is the reason that the sun oven gets so hot, and that retains the airtight seal. But the reflectors are made of a highly polished anodized aluminum. They're 86% reflective, but they'll never oxidize, rust, or corrode, and they clean just like glass. You use Windex or vinegar water to clean the glass, and they polish right up. And over time, the reflectors get scratched and dinged and dented, but that doesn't affect the performance. It's just the cosmetics of it. And by the way, the reflectors never get hot. So if they have small children and they come and touch the reflectors, they're never going to burn themselves because they don't get hot. The outer box of the sun oven is made of ABS plastic. The inner box or inner shell is made of anodized aluminum, and the anodized aluminum is really easy to clean. If you spill anything, you can just wipe it right out or spray it with a garden hose. But between the aluminum inner box and the plastic outer box is a very thick bat of a food-grade fiberglass insulation. And by the way, that's extremely important. Some people make homemade solar ovens using building insulation, which can be toxic. And if you are baking breads and things in it, you could actually, you know, as toxic fumes can come out of it. The insulation we use is actually designed for pizza ovens, and it's a food-grade insulation. But the nice thing is, with that insulation, it can be 400 degrees inside the sun oven. You can touch anywhere on the outer box, the outer plastic box, and you might feel a little bit warm from sitting in the direct sunlight, but you're not going to actually have any heat escaping from it. The only part of the oven that gets hot when you're cooking that's exposed is the glass door. And the glass of the All-American Sun Oven is made of a low iron tempered glass. By the way, low iron glass is very expensive. It's about four times the cost of regular tempered glass. But by taking the iron content out of the glass, it then allows for more sunlight to get into the oven chamber. But when it's 350 degrees inside the sun oven, the outside temperature of the glass is about 155 degrees Fahrenheit, which will sting if you touch it, but it's not going to burn. There is an advantage to that glass getting hot, and that is it'll keep your neighbor's dog from eating your pot roast. Any animal that's out in the daytime will sense the heat and will stay away from the sun oven. There are animals out at night that probably wouldn't sense the heat and stay away from the sun oven, but most people don't do a lot of solar cooking at night, so you don't have to worry too much about that. And there's a frame or a bezel on the sun oven that It's made of a wood. It's a kiln-dried poplar wood. And the only maintenance we suggest you do to the sun oven is every 5 years or so, you should treat the wood with some linseed oil or some exterior wood stain. And if you do that, then the sun oven will last a lifetime. Next. The sun oven is warrantied. The reflectors and gasket are both warrantied for 15 years. And there's also a 30-day satisfaction guarantee with the sun oven that if you get it and for any reason you're not happy, you can turn it in the first 30 days and get your money back next. I just want to mention briefly what we do around the world and why we do it. We have projects all over the world, and we're very passionate about our work internationally. There's still over 2 billion people in the world who cook with wood or charcoal or animal dung as their primary cooking fuel. And when a woman cooks over a wood or charcoal fire, she inhales the same amount of smoke as smoking 3 packs of cigarettes a day. Each year in the continent of Africa alone, 1.6 million children under the age of 5 die of respiratory diseases, primarily from the indoor air pollution of cooking fires. So when we can replace that smoke with a sun oven, it has a huge effect on the health of women and children. And it also, when women go out together, wood, sometimes they're susceptible to rape and attack. And so there's so many advantages to replacing wood and charcoal in developing countries with the sun, and that's what we try to do. Next. We have a very simple business model. Our goal is to try to help people in the U.S. save energy and be prepared for emergencies, and then we use a portion of the sales to work in third world countries. Those of you who have sun ovens, I want to thank you because that's how we fund our work. We don't solicit money for projects. What we try to do is help people save energy and prepare for emergencies. The picture on the screen there has some of the family size ovens, and behind it you see the villager sun oven we mentioned earlier. And the villager sun ovens can make, as I said, 1,200 meals in an 8-hour day or 28 loaves of bread an hour. But very much related to emergency preparedness, we're trying to get as many villager sun ovens into orphanages around the world as possible. Now, we subsidize the cost of those. The last time the price of a villager sun oven was increased was in 1997, so it's been 19 years since the last price increase. And what we do is we subsidize the cost with the sale of the global sun ovens and the all-American sun ovens. But our goal basically is to get them into the orphanages because, let's say an orphanage has 200 kids, they're only going to need 400 meals a day. They don't need 1,200 meals. So when we ship it, we ship a whole bakery package. It has 150 different pots and pans and insect-proof flour containers and pretty much everything that's needed for a total turnkey bakery. The orphanage can then bake bread in the off hours and sell bread, and then they can generate their own income flow. Now, the U.S. has been a very generous donor to orphans and orphanages around the world. I'm sure many of you support orphanages, but part of emergency preparedness, many of us are really concerned about where the U.S. economy is going. And if the economy goes south, there's really a good chance that donations to things like orphanages around the world are going to drop off. So if they have a source of income, then they'll have a way of being self-reliant or self-sufficient and hopefully be able to continue. So again, those of you who have ovens, I want to thank you because that's what helps us with our work. Well, Ron, maybe we can take some more questions at this point.
Okay, I've got a question from Will. He said, what kind of cookware can be used in the sun oven?
I'm going to defer that question because the very next slide answers it. So okay. I'll explain that in more detail on the next the next slide.
The next one is, how do you control the temperature? That's for Martha.
Okay. Basically, the more often you realign the sun oven, if you align it every 30 minutes, you keep it at the maximum temperature. But the nice thing is, because nothing burns, you never worry about getting too hot, and you can cook things for a longer time at a lower temperature without them drying out. So you don't have to be exacting in temperatures the way you would be if you're going to be cooking in your regular oven. So you just, if you want to do it as quickly as possible, just realign it every 30 minutes. If not, just kind of determine when you want to eat. Set the sun oven where the sun's going to be halfway in the time from when it is right now. Let's say it's 1 in the afternoon, you know you want to eat at 5. Just set the sun oven facing south where the sun's going to, southwest where the sun's going to be at 3 o'clock. Come back at 5 o'clock and your meal will be cooked.
Okay, and then Brian asks, what is the hottest the sun oven can get?
The absolute hottest is 400, very consistently 350, 360. On really clear days, 400 is where it pretty well maxes out.
Okay. And the next one is from Holly. Is how do you clean it? Because it seems like if the sun bakes the food, if you spill food and the sun bakes it, it'd be hard to get off.
Okay, well, a couple of things with the cleaning. One is anything you're going to cook in the sun oven, with the exception of bakery goods, you do cook in a pot or pan with a lid on it or a baking bag, so you don't get splattering in the sun oven the way you would in a regular oven. The only time you need to clean it is if you're like me and you spill things, which I do fairly often. I'm pretty clumsy. My wife and I have this ongoing disagreement about how you clean a sun oven. My wife will take a dish rag, she'll put some dish soap on it, she'll rub it very carefully, and then she rinses the dish rag once or twice to make sure there's no soap residue on it. I just turn it on the side and spray it with a garden hose. So it's just a man's way of doing it or a woman's way. But you know, you can spray it with a garden hose if it really gets messy on the inside, but or just wipe it out. The inner box is made of a black anodized aluminum, which is very durable, and so you can rub things pretty easily, and it's not at all difficult to clean.
Yeah, we did a chili cook-off, and we cooked our chili in our sun oven last year, and I spilled it in there, and all I did was I left it pointing towards the sun. We were in a hurry, so I left it pointing towards the sun, and I just sprayed like soapy water in there, and just kind of, I think I wrung it out of the dish rag, just wrung out some soapy water on it and just left it pointing towards the sun, came back, and it just wiped right out. So after we came back from the competition, which we won, by the way.
Oh, congratulations. That's all sun-cooked means. All right.
Okay, we're good to go.
Okay, we'll keep going here next, and now we'll answer that question, the first question we had about pots and pans. And any kind of pot or pan that's oven safe can be used in the sun oven. So as long as it's oven safe, it can be used. However, the most efficient kind of pots to cook in are the enamelware pots. Enamelware is an enamel coated with steel. It's like the turkey roaster that you probably have at home. And the reason the enamelware is the most efficient is it's thin and it's dark. Now, earlier I mentioned making a 3-pound chicken, that you could put a 3-pound chicken in the sun oven. If you realigned it every 30 minutes, you could cook it in about an hour and a half. Well, if you wanted to cook as quickly as possible, the enamelware is best because it's thin. Remember I mentioned the whole chamber in the sun oven has an even heat, so the more mass you have in it, the longer it takes to cook. However, if I was going to slow cook the chicken or anything I was going to slow cook and leave unattended all day, then I like using a Dutch oven or a cast iron pot. Now, a Dutch oven takes an hour and a half longer to come up to temperature than the enamelware pot will. So you don't want to use a Dutch oven for something you want to cook quickly because it takes a long time to come up to temperature. The benefit of the Dutch oven is that if you're going to slow cook all day and you know it's going to be sunny in the morning, once the Dutch oven has gotten hot, you can just take the Dutch oven out of the sun, leave the Dutch oven in the sun oven, and the retained heat from that cast iron will allow the food to finish cooking even if the sun completely disappears. So for slow cooking, the cast iron pots are great. Or if you like to use glassware, a lot of people like using Corningware or Pyrex. That works real well in the sun oven. Keep in mind, glassware is going to take about 15% longer than you would than an enamelware. So with most things, if you can use glassware, you just started, 15, 20 minutes earlier, and it works fine. Our viewers like using silicone bread pans and muffin pans because they can stuff a whole bunch of them in the sun oven and store them that way. That works great. Stoneware works great. The only thing you want to be cautious of is if you're going to use a shiny pot, like a stainless steel pot. That reflects light out of the sun oven and really slows down your cooking time. But if you take, you can still use it, just take a dark dish towel, cover over the shiny part of the pot so it doesn't reflect the light out, and it worked just fine. Same thing if you're going to use like a casserole dish with aluminum foil. We suggest you put the shiny side of the foil facing the food and then still put a dark dish towel over the dull side of it. So, again, anything you cook in the sun oven other than bakery goods, you do have to cook in a pot or pan with a lid to trap that moisture inside, or the baking bag, but any kinds of pots or pans can be used. Next, I want to talk a little bit about water. And when you make, you can of course boil water in the sun oven, and you can bring water to boil in it, but if you want to, you can pasteurize water. Boiling and pasteurizing kills all the biological contaminants in water, and they both pretty much do the same thing. The one advantage of boiling is, of course, you see the bubbles, so you know the water is safe to drink when you see bubbles. Well, there's a little device that's available for the sun ovens. It'll be part of a package we'll be talking about in a couple minutes. It's called a WAPI, or water pasteurization indicator. And you can pasteurize water in the sun oven. Water pasteurizes by bringing it to a temperature above 150 degrees Fahrenheit for 6 minutes. And that kills the same biological contaminants that boiling does, just in a lot less time. Well, there's a little device called a WAPI, or water pasteurization indicator. It just floats on the top of a pot or a pan or a canning jar. And then what happens is it's got a plastic tube with a green wax in it. When the wax melts and goes to the bottom, then you know your water is pasteurized. You can take it out of the water. The wax will re-harden in less than 2 minutes. You just turn the plastic tube over and have the wax on top, and you can reuse it hundreds of times. So some people keep a piece of cheesecloth with their sun oven. That way, if they've gathered water from a stream or roof, they can pour the water through the cheesecloth. That will filter any solid impurities out of it, and then they can boil or pasteurize it in the sun oven. Next, I want to talk about dehydrating. And there's a number of things that are really great about dehydrating in the sun. One is that if you ever had a time when your garden was ready to be harvested and you couldn't use your electric dehydrator because you didn't have electricity, it's great for that. But some people like doing their, garlic or onions or peppers or jerky, things that are smelly, and like doing them outside. Or if you've got herbs and things, sun-drying herbs actually preserves a lot more of the nutrients in it. Next, so when you dry in the sun oven, when you dry in the sun oven, the many foods are come out really good when they're made in the sun oven. There's racks that are available for the sun oven, and we call them dehydrating and baking racks. And there's three racks that are available. They'll be part of the package we'll talk about in a few minutes. And you can then, with the All-American sun oven, it gives you 4 layers of drying or dehydrating. You do want to cut things when you cut them. You want to cut them as thin as possible. The thinner they are, the faster they dry. You want to keep them about a half inch apart from each other, and they work really well. They come with a roll of parchment paper, and keep in mind you can reuse each piece of parchment paper someplace between 6 to 12 times, and it works really well. Next. The other thing, when you may wonder, because I was talking about it having an airtight seal, that, how do you dry? Well, basically, there's two latches that latch the glass door of the sun oven shut. If you take one of the latches, you turn it in towards the center of the sun oven, and then put the glass on top of it, that leaves a gap of air and allows moist air to escape out of the sun oven and keeps it from getting too hot. Most things you want to dry at a temperature someplace between 110 and 155 degrees Fahrenheit. When you get up to 180, you're cooking. So herbs you want to dry a little lower temperature. You want to dry those at about 100 degrees Fahrenheit. But what I generally do when I'm going to dry in the sun oven is I'll take the sun oven, I'll line it where the sun currently is, then I move it back towards the east, or move it out of the sun about 6 inches, so that it's not in full direct sun, and that keeps it in that temperature range of 110 to 155 degrees, and it's ideal for being able to then dry or dehydrate. Next. Now, we put together a special package for tonight's class, and before I go to the questions, I'm just going to briefly mention all the things that are in it. We are offering it at a 30% discount, and it's got just everything that you pretty much need to cook, as well as to be better prepared for cooking the sun next. So the items that are included in the package is that there's a set of stackable pots. These are 2 3-quart pots, and they're actually made by Graniteware, Columbian Home Products, the company that's been making them for more than 100 years. They're made in the United States. And what's different about them is they customize them for us to put an indented base in them so that they can stack too high. And when they stack too high, then you can cook two different things at the same time. And they come with a glass lid and a domed lid. I do want to mention, by the way, with the pots, there is enough room that if you wanted to, you could cook in the two pots, then you could take 2-quart-size canning jars and mason jars and put it next to it and cook side dishes. You can cook 4 different things at the same time. So you're not limited to cooking one thing as long as it fits in the sun oven. This time of year, I live in DeKalb County, Illinois, and all over the country see signs for DeKalb corn, and that's where it comes from. I'm surrounded by cornfields right now. We have so much corn, and if you want the most delicious sweet corn you've ever eaten, you can be cooking in those two pots. Just take your corn, leave it in the husk, dip it into a bucket of water or run it under a water faucet, and you could then put between the sides and on top of the pots, you could put 8 or 10 ears of corn. And when you peel back that corn, it literally melts, put some butter and salt on it, literally melts in your mouth. So that will stack right around the pots, so you're not at all limited. Next, the package also includes the water pasteurization indicator. As I mentioned, there's a tube when the wax melts and goes to the bottom, then you know the water is pasteurized. We call this a multi-fuel WAPI. There are water pasteurization indicators that are just designed to use in solar ovens, but you can use this with butane or propane or a wood fire. And again, it would allow you to then pasteurize water, which is more than twice as fast as boiling, using any type of fuel. So even if you had times you weren't going to do it in the sun oven, you can use this with any other type of fuel. Next, it also comes with a set of bread pans, so you can bake. It comes with 2 bread pans next, as well as coming with the multi-level dehydrating baking rack set. And besides just for drying or dehydrating, you can use these racks for cookies. You can do 4 layers of cookies or flatbreads or quiches. Believe me, I know a lot about baking cookies. We broke the Guinness Book of World Records record for cooking the largest number of cookies that have ever been cooked. And we did it in sun ovens in Miami, Florida, as a fundraiser to raise money to send sun ovens to Haiti. And we cooked thousands of cookies in it all in 1 hour. So it was amazing. We had a federal judge that moderated and gave the official record keeping, and it was quite an organized event. But it was a lot of fun. So it's great for cookies as well as for using it for drying or dehydrating. Next. The package also then includes what we call a cloudy day cube stove. Now, this isn't used with the sun oven. This is a backup for the sun oven. It's a simple little cube stove. It only weighs a pound. It's got 7 different positions. You can adjust it so that you can cook faster or slower. You can use it with virtually any kind of a fuel. Next, but the most efficient type of fuel to use with it are the cloudy day fuel disk fire starters. And these cloudy day fuel disk fire starters, there's 2 of them that come with the cloudy day cube stove and then 10 additional ones. What's great is these disks are incredible. You can break them into pieces and each disk can start 5 or 6 fires. It also, they've got a really unlimited shelf life, and they're made of recycled material. They're totally non-toxic. So we're including a total of 12 of these discs, 2 that come with the cloudy day cube stove, and another 10 discs that are included. So there's a total of 12 of them. Next. And in addition to that, there's a computer CD that comes with the sun oven that's got 600 recipes and a state-of-the-art recipe software called Cookin. And Cookin software is astounding. It's amazing. If our recipe is for 4 people and you want it for 7, you just change the number of servings and it adjusts the portions. Now, sometimes people ask, why would you have a computer software included for preparedness? Well, the idea is that we hope you'll be prepared. We hope that you take and look through the recipes, match the recipes to what you know the food you're going to have, adjust it for the number of people, number of servings you want, and then print it out. With the Cookin software, if you like keeping your recipes on 3x5 cards, you can, or notebook size. And that Cookin software, if you go to the Cookin website, sells for $79. And that's included. And there's also a preparedness for life package, that a program that's included on that's got a whole emergency preparedness planning program that sells on the Cookin' website for $29, and that's included in the package. Next. So this package is available just for a limited time, and if you go to the Sun Oven website just to buy the package, you'll find that it costs $448. But if you buy it as part of this by Friday, as part of this class, basically, then you only pay $315, and the shipping anywhere in the continental or the contiguous 48 states is included. And by the way, unless you have the oven shipped to Illinois, there's no sales tax. So the $315 is the total price for the package. And next, and so it's a huge savings of 30%. But this offer is only good till Friday, so it's not going to be around a long time. But you can, if you take advantage of it now, it will really is a huge savings. Next. And I do want to remind you that when you do get a Sun Oven, it helps us with our work around the world. The picture on the screen, I took a project I was working on in Sri Lanka after the tsunami, where we installed Sun Ovens in several new homes that were built in some of the big villager Sun Ovens in community centers. Next. So this package is available. Now, we mentioned in some of the literature we sent out earlier that if you registered for the class, you would get a cookbook. We've got an incredible cookbook that we've put together of 101 of our favorite meat recipes. So we call it Prepared Meat Thy Baker, but it's really incredible recipes. And everybody who pre-registered will get a copy of this tomorrow via email or link to an ebook that's got this 101 recipes in it. Next. And so this package is going to be available, but we're adding one more extra bonus. If you do get, if you, the first 100 people to buy will be able to get an extra hanging turkey roasting rack. The turkey roasting rack allows you to bake up to an 18-pound turkey. It makes it much easier to get out, and that sells for an additional $35. So besides for saving the $133, you get another $35 bonus. If you're wondering if you're amongst the first button, the first 100 people, as long as the button below says the word turkey rack on it, you know you're still included with this extra bonus of getting the hanging turkey rack. So there's a button down below that will take you to a page on our website. You can place your order, and the total price will only be $315, including shipping. And unless you're in the state of Illinois, there's no sales tax. So the total price for everything is $315, which is a huge savings. Well, Ron, I know we're running a little bit over, but did we get any additional questions?
Yeah, we did. Let's see here. Holly asks that... Isn't plastic when heated up bad for you?
Yes. But I'm.
I think she's referring to the outside of it being plastic, maybe.
Oh, okay. The outside of the oven is made of ABS plastic, but the inner box is made of anodized aluminum. And then when the inner box is assembled, there's actually a high temperature silicone caulk on the part not inside the oven, the part you don't see. So it's a totally airtight chamber, and so there's no issues then that you have to be concerned that there's any plastic at all anywhere in the interior that's exposed to your food. And also, because of the thick bat of insulation between the anodized aluminum inner box and the plastic outer box, there's no place where the no time that the plastic actually gets hot at all from the oven, so there's nothing that's plastic that has anything to do with your food or anywhere near your food.
Okay. And then Will asked, which I think you've answered this, but can you cook multiple things inside the Sun Oven? And obviously, yes. I mean, we do it as well. We've cooked, we do like chicken and rice in a mason jar, and then right next to that, we'll do like a peach cobbler. And then do a lot of mason jar recipes, and those actually turn out really good.
Yeah, no, it's great. And with the stackable pots, you can actually cook the chicken and rice in the bottom and the cobbler on top. And so many people have there's one gentleman who owned a store that I used to teach a lot of classes at. And every time he'd introduce me, he said that just about every Sunday before they go to church, they put a chicken in the bottom and a cobbler on top, set the Sun Oven. The Sun's going to be halfway in the time in church and come back from church, and it's done. And he said, done it probably 100 times. I can't believe you can cook a cobbler and a roast chicken at exactly the same temperature for exactly the same length of time and still have them both come out perfect. But that's the amazing thing about cooking in the sun.
Yeah, I agree. It's totally amazing. The other one was Melissa asked, how often do you need to move the sun oven in order to cook your food?
Well, if you realign it every 30 minutes, you keep it at the maximum temperature. So you can do it from once a day by slow cooking and just leaving it in one place, or to maximize the temperature for things like bread, I do realign it every 30 minutes.
Okay. And I think that's about it.
Alrighty. Well, thank you so much for giving me the opportunity to share and be part of this first Back Porch. We saw you eating there on the screen, and I don't know if everybody else could see it, but you're making me hungry. How did the chicken come out?
So. Man, it came out perfect. I just thought it was rude to eat it on camera, so I just kind of like dabbled off to the side a little bit. But yeah, it turned out perfect as always, you know, Paul. We've been using the sun oven probably for, six years now. Six and a half years I've been using the sun oven here. We still use the same sun oven we got originally. And so it's gotten 6 years worth of pretty good abuse because my seven kids are not very gentle. And, it still looks, it almost looks just as good as the day we bought it, other than it's a little bit dirtier. I need to wipe off the reflectors a little bit. But other than that, I mean, it's it still cooks our Sunday dinners all the time. It still cooks cobblers for us all the time. It does a great job, Paul. You really made a great product here.
Oh, thank you so much. Well, we look forward to seeing you next month in Florida. So looking forward to joining you at the show in Lakeland. And what, I guess only about 3 weeks from now. So
yeah. Yeah, so we'll see you down there, and hopefully we'll have some more classes down there and teach more people how to cook with the sun.
Great. Look forward to it. Thanks a lot. God bless.
Thanks, Paul. You take care, bud. And thanks, everybody, for joining us for our first Back Porch Chats, and hopefully you guys enjoyed it. If you guys have any feedback, if you guys would like us to do something else, or you'd like us to cover a different topic, you know, feel free to shoot us an email. And we'll send out an email to everybody just so you have that email, and go ahead and respond to that. And any further questions will be answered in that email, as well as if you guys have suggestions or topics that you really want covered, I'll make sure to make those a priority in our future Back Porch Chats. Thanks, guys, and let's see here. So we'll be able to provide email addresses and we'll send that out in an email to everybody. So hopefully that works out. See, one more question here. You spoke being able to contact you guys after the webinar. Let's see, you will provide your, yes, well, yeah. Sorry, Mike, yes. Well, we'll provide our email address to you. We'll make sure to answer any and all questions for you guys. So again, I appreciate you guys. We do this for you guys. We hope that it helps you. We hope that we were able to teach you guys something new. I've learned something new, and I've listened to Paul's presentations several times, and I always learn something new from his presentation. So thanks again, Paul. I appreciate it. You're always a great teacher. And hopefully we'll see you guys on our next one. Take care, guys. We'll talk to you later.